introductory part of computers, types of programming languages, and all other stuffs, introductory stuffs. From this lecture, I'm going to start with the second chapter, that is fundamentals of C programming language. This chapter contains a lot of theories, right? So teaching a lot of theories and learning a lot of theories will make subjects so boring. I will make sure that I don't make this boring, so that's why I have included so many programs in this chapter. So as much as I give importance to theory, I'll also show you the practical implementation of that theory in the program, in our C program. So we are going to perform a C program from this chapter. But you can see the topics over here, like these are the topics we are going to study in this chapter. I'm just not going to list these topics and increase the duration of this video, but you can just understand that these are the topics which are going to be covered in this chapter, right? So let's begin. So first of all, we are going to study, or we are going to know about the features of C programming language. Whatever we are going to study, we have to know the unique features, right? So we are going to see how C is having different features. First of all, C is very structured language. We can define blocks and we can define scope for the C program. Now, what is the scope? We are going to study that in the chapter of functions, because it is very needful there. Right now, you just understand that C is very structured language. Then, in first chapter, we have studied that C is a higher level language, which is similar to English language. But in this chapter itself, we are going to study about some operation which can be performed in C programming language, which deals with 0 and 1 bits, say machine level language. These are the operations that can be performed at machine level, right? So we can also say that C is a middle level language, and that is the reason why C is the fastest language. Sometimes the same program which is written in C as well as in Python, it may happen that the speed of execution of the Python program is lesser than that of the C programming language. In modern programming language, we have got some ability to make the Python program faster, but in real time scenario, it may happen. So C is very efficient and faster language. C language is really very portable. By means of this word portable, I want to say that suppose you have written a program in your device, and then you just take this program and plug into another device and execute that with different operating system and some kind of modification, it will easily run, right? So C is really very portable language. C is having 32 keywords. What is this keyword? We are going to study in this chapter itself. As I have already told you, this chapter contains a lot of theories, and you have to remember that to make the further study easy, right? Then after, the last but not the least is, you can also write, say, application level programs or system programs or system softwares in C programming language. So if you want, you can also make compilers, you can also make operating system in C programming language. These are the system softwares, and you can also make application softwares as well. So these are the features of C. Then after, we are going to talk about one very important topic, that is different data types available in C programming language. Now just forget that you are sitting in the PPS lecture. Just imagine that you are sitting in the maths lecture, mathematics. I'm telling you to add 1 and 2. Just 1 and 2. So what you are exactly doing? You are going to perform addition of 2 whole numbers. By means of this whole number, I want to tell you that you are dealing with integers. Now integers can be positive or integers can be negative, right? So integers are nothing but plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to infinity, minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to infinity, and 0. But what if I tell you that add 1.2 plus 1.2? What will be the answer? The answer will be 2.4. These are not integers numbers. These are floating point numbers, which is having decimal values, which is having fractions, right? Sometimes I may tell you that enter your name inside the program. You are not entering integer. You are not entering floating point, but you are entering characters, right? Sequence of character. So based on this thing, you have to tell computer that what kind of data you are going to use. Computer will not know automatically, especially in case of C. You have to manually tell computer that this data I am going to use and this data is having this kind of type. This type. That is called data types. Now data types can be further divided into three types. Primary data type, then it is say user defined data type, and then derived data type. In this lecture, I am going to talk about only the primary data type. What is this primary data type? Primary data type is nothing but the data type already available in our program. Say integer, float, and characters. We are going to see the chart next slide only, so don't worry. These are called primary data types. You don't need to make them. If I just give you introduction about user-defined data type, then in user-defined data type, user is going to make a data type. Here I used unit data, unit word to define my data type. But even if I want my data type to be named as Komal, K-O-M-A-L, then I can make that too. User-defined data type, user can give any name. And then derived data type, which is nothing but created based on primary data type. We are going to study different chapters on structures, pointers, functions and all that. So we are going to study in detail this kind of data types. Right? Now, what are this primary data type? Primary data type. First, I have told you that first is integer, second is float, third is character. Sorry, here first is character, but you just adjusted the sequence. And last but not least is void. Void means nothing. I'll show you through the program that how void data type can be used. Right now you just understand that primary data type can be further divided into four parts: character, integer, float and void. These are also further divided using some qualifiers, that is long, short, signed, unsigned. These are qualifiers. What is the need of these qualifiers? See, if I'm telling you that the number is unsigned, unsigned means I'm not having any kind of sign. So if I'm writing 1, that means I cannot write plus 1 or minus 1. I have to simply write 1. Now come to the C programming language. Just leave the math language, math lecture. Come to the C programming lecture. Now, if I'm telling you the number is just 1, no plus, no minus, what do you understand? By default, 1 is considered as positive numbers. So, unsigned integer can range from 0 to positive infinity, like say infinity. But if I tell you signed integer, right? If I tell you signed integer, that means number can have sign, plus or minus. So, the range will be minus infinity to plus infinity including 0. Same way, short and long is also used to increase the size. So here I cannot just draw everything and tell you that how short and long and signed and unsigned used to change the size of this integer, float or character data type. But in live lectures I'm going to talk about this. So while making notes for live lectures, please make sure that you pay more attention to this concept, that how qualifiers can be used to change the range of this data types, primary data types. Now, let us begin with the first C program. Let's just begin that and just see that how the C program can work, how we can write our first C program. The user-defined data type and derived data type we are going to study in next lectures, because I just want to show you how C program run first. So let's begin that. So here you can see the computer screen, right? Okay. Now, to write any C program, you need Integrated Development Environment, in short, IDE, where you can write a program, compile a program, and run the program, and get some output. Which IDEs can be used? Your choice. You can use any IDE that you are comfortable with. You can use code blocks, you can use VS Code, you can use AOC++, or even if you want, you can use Turbo C also. But nowadays Turbo C is not being used by so many users, but yeah, you can use that too. Right? So you can use any IDE. If you are not having proper device at your home or internet, if you are at least having internet connection, then you can also use some online IDEs. Online, there are so many IDEs available, so that you do not need to install that software inside your device. You can just directly go to the internet, that site. Sites like CodeShare, HackerRank, HackerRank, Leaks4Gigs, this sites provide online IDE. So you can use any of them. In our lectures, I'm going to use DevC++ because I like that. It's very simple to use. So that's why I use DevC++. So just here I have installed, you can see the icon over here, DevC++, and here is the screen. You can see the screen over here, over my back. This screen, you can see. Now, if you want to run a new program, you can directly go to the file and new, and inside new, you can go to the project or simply press Ctrl plus N. New file will be open. Now, first, as it is our first program, I'm just going to write some lines and then I'll tell you how these lines are important. First, I'm writing something like my first. My first C program, right? It is not necessary to write that. That I'm going to tell you. Then include stdio.h space int main. Then return 0. This is the structure of C. You have to remember everything and you have to write these things in this manner only. Here in C programming language, semicolon is must. If you forget the semicolon, then you will encounter an error. So make sure that you put semicolon at proper place. Now, in our first program, I just want you to print your name, or say I just want you to print hello world, good morning. I just want you to print this on the screen, not by just typing good morning or hello world, but by just writing a program which will print this on behalf of you, right? So here I'm writing print f, not just print, but print f in the brackets inside the inverted comma. I'm going to write hello world, good morning. And after each line completes, we have to put semicolon. Except for some topics, I'll tell you about that. But by default, we have to put semicolon after each lines of code in C programming language. Now, to run this program, first we have to save this. So Control S, and then I'm just writing P1, that means program 1. By default, the extension of C programming language will be .c. You can use .cpp or something like that. But here you don't need to put p1.c or something like that. It will be automatically selected in the save as type. But you must know this kind of thing, because each file must have some kind of extension. So just save this program. I am saving it in my desktop. If you want, you can save it in a simple folder also. Just try yourself to save it in simple folder so that you can have proper collection of these programs which we are going to perform in our YouTube class as well as in live classes, right? So this program is saved now. How do you know that you can see p1.cpp over here, right? So this program is saved now. I want to know the output, so that's why I have to run this. So go to this execute menu. Inside this, first you have to compile this. we have already talked about the compilers and interpreters, and so you know that what exactly the task of compiler is. Every program must be compiled before we are going to execute it. So compile the program. If my program is having no error, then it will show me this success status, which shows the compilation time. Suppose I have just forgot to put a semicolon over here, right? I forgot to put semicolon over here. Now, if I just save this program and compile it, it will show me the error that expected dot semicolon before return. So before this return, it is expecting semicolon. That means it is expecting semicolon over here. If you are not closing one bracket, and if I'm just saving this program, compile it, you can see that expected bracket at the end of input. So after this, it is expecting some kind of brackets. So C is very easy. It will show you the errors. But you need to understand this error and correct it. So this is our first program. It is errorless, and that's why if I'm compiling right now, it will show me that there is no extra errors. So I can just run it over here. You can also use F9 and F10 as a shortcut key. Now you can see the output over here. Hello world, good morning. So hello world, good morning is printed over here. Now you must be wondering that, ma'am, whatever you have entered in as hello world, good morning is kind of characters. Yeah, it is character, but it is not needed. We don't bother about the data type when it is written inside the inverted comma. We bother about the data type when it is first of all, you just understand the syntax. And data type is needed when we are using variables. Now I'll show you that how variables can be printed. But before that, I like to explain this program a bit. This first line, you can see this, we cannot see anywhere inside the output. If I just run this program again, you can see this my first C program is written, it's not written anywhere. Where it's gone? Magic. No, it is not kind of magic, but this is called comments. Comments. We are going to talk about this comments, but right now just understand that comments is used for developers who are going to develop a program. Suppose it may happen that right now I'm writing the program. Now I just leave my job and some other faculty is coming over here, or other developer coming over here. How would the developer know that what exactly the things have been done? So I can write comments. Comments can be of single line. Whatever comment I have written over here is single line comment. This comment can also be multi-line. For that, this symbol is used. Comments can be multi-line too. Right? So this is the symbol of right? So you can see comments can be this also. If you are using just this only, this is not blue color. So that means this is not considered as comment. And if I just save this program, compile it, it will show me an error. Does not name a type. So it does not consider it as a comment. So you have to use multi-line comment for more than one lines. So comments can be used just for the sake of understanding. If you can also, it is optional, you can also eliminate that. Then this include English word, that means we are going to include something, we are going to add something. What we are going to add? stdio.h, that is standard input output dot h file. This is the file externally placed, and we are going to include it in our program for some purpose. Each file must have some kind of extension, and you know that, right? Each file must have some kind of extension. Document file is having .doc extension. Image file is having .jpg or .png extension. Text file is having .txt extension. Same way, this file is having .h extension, which is nothing but header file. Header file. See, I have written a comment over here for the sake of purpose, for make you understand this concept. Header file contains so many functions. Suppose I have written printf over here. How my computer would know that what it must do when it encounters this word printf, it should give the output on the screen. But how would my computer know? This definition is written over this header file, and that's why I have to include it. If I am not including this, then by default, what will happen if I am not including this? If I compile this, you can see printf was not declared in the scope. So that means my compiler cannot understand what exactly this printf is. But if I just include this header file, it will know that printf means I have to print something. So when it scan, see, first of all, I have included something. So compiler knows that the external file has been included. Then it will encounter to the next line, which is nothing but the int main. Int is a data type, as you already know, and we define main. This is the function. This is the unique function of C program. You cannot use main brackets any other second time in your program. You can just use it only first time. Also, one mistake students used to do is they used to put semicolon over here. Semicolon means my program or my line is just completed its execution over this line. So you do not need to put a semicolon. You must not put semicolon over here. So int main, and as you have written int over here, you have to write return over here, and that concept we are going to cover in our functions chapter. So till then, you just have to mug up that int main. If you are writing int main, you have to write return over here. You can also write void main over here, but if I am writing void main in my C++, it will not consider, you know, it will be considered as an error in C++. If you are using Turbo C or any other IDEs, you can also use void main. But if I am using it right now, it will throw me an error, so I am not using it throughout the lectures, and I am going to use int main only. So the purpose of main function is to tell compiler that my program starts from here, right? And this line will not be printed because it is comment. It is just for the sake of understanding purpose. Then printf. When the control comes over here, the compiler does not know what is printf is. So it will go through the external file which is included over here, and we'll see if it can find printf over there. If yes, then it will see the definition and work accordingly. In the definition, it will see when it will encounter printf, it have to print something on the screen. So it will print whatever is inside this bracket. And this is the syntax. You have to mug up the syntax. You have to be habituated with the syntax. You cannot write any program without this syntax. Now, what will be the change if I tell you that instead of hello but good morning, you have to print your name on the screen? You just need to change here. Suppose I want to print Komal. You just need to change this, save this, compile this again. You have to compile the change and run it. You can see the Komal over here, right? So this is how you can run your first program. In our next lecture, I'm going to tell you that how data type is important in this kind of program. So in next lecture, I'm going to perform the data types, operations based on data types, right? I hope you enjoyed this class. If you have any doubt, you can comment below the comment section, or you can also ask me throughout our live classes about these doubts. Thank you so much.